when you're a kid, you know, you play everything. I like football and had success at it. Well, I started out, I went to the Air Force Academy Prep School out of high school. When I was down there, my mother was diagnosed with terminal cancer, and so I got an emergency leave. I'd been recruited by Oregon State out of high school. Tommy Prother was a coach there. He referred me to Dave Holmes, who was the head coach at Eastern at that time. I just got the job. And all of a sudden I got a phone call from Eastern. I says, I will be there when you tell me to be there. Eastern hadn't won a ball game in 2 years. And so the first year was a fairly lean year. In 1967, under Dave Holmes, we played for the national championship. I was a student coach in 67. He got the head job at the University of Hawaii, and I was one of two assistants he took. That kind of started my coaching career. I was lucky and got the job at CBC. I had some success there and then got the job at Eastern. Dr. Fredrickson, who was the president of Eastern when I was hired, had a vision for Eastern that was different than other regional universities in Washington and Oregon. To change how they appeared was athletics. I was a hard-nosed guy. I wasn't necessarily a disciplinarian as I was do it right.
And they got the most out of you. As I look back on it, it helps me today.
Whether it was in the weight room, whether it was on the field, whether it was as a teammate, he never stopped.
Coach Zornes to lift weights, come in there and lift it more than most all the players on the bench press. He come in there and put up, I mean, just rep 315 like it was nobody's business. Always trying to make you a better player.
We recruited kids that were undersized at skill positions. Lineman was probably our biggest asset. We especially like to get kids out the basketball court. We knew what we could do with them through a strength program. We started out with no scholarships and then went to 20. But by 1984, we were up to the 60 scholarships. Unfortunately, in 84, we took a financial cut and had to drop back down.
So he was really trying to make things work with, you know, what they call a shoestring budget, I guess, if you will. I wore the same pair of cleats for 2 years. We wore the same uniforms for 2 years too as well. One day we come to practice and he's like, we're low on money. Nobody gets their ankles taped, man, during practice, only during games.
We played Northern Arizona. Ron Raver came in the office and he said, we've just taken a budget cut. He says, I don't know if we can play. And I said, well, we've already bought the plane tickets. And I said, we've already got the bus lined up. And I said, if you will give us enough money to have a pregame meal, we will play the game. We will round up money. We'll take the bus down and we'll sleep in the airport and we will fly out the next morning. We'll give each kid 15 bucks to buy food. We flew up, got on the bus, went up, ate the pregame meal, went to Northern Arizona, beat them, got on the bus, drove back down, slept in the airport, got on the plane and flew back. And that was the first Big Sky win.
We were set out, hey, you're the underdogs. You know, you got to come out here ready to play. You know, strap up, put your boots on, and let's go for it.
I just felt like, hey, we are who we are, and let's be who we are.
Being independent, I really believe that was a spark. You know, that was a stepping stone. You know, and then from then, it just grew.
In 85, we were good. In 84, we beat a good Idaho team right after they beat Oregon State. And then we beat Idaho in the playoffs in 85.
You know, we need to prove to these guys that we belong in the Big Sky. And we're beating these teams. That's a sense of pride.
Here in 1985, 86, when Eastern didn't get in the Big Sky, there was a lot of disappointment. But then we ended up winning 9 football games, beat Idaho in the playoffs.
And when we finally got in, probably we were less ready to get in from a budget standpoint, but we got in. I became the athletic director in 90, and first thing I made sure we did is we got back our scholarship load up to 60, and then we were able to build our program back up until we won the Big Sky in 92. We beat Boise State at home for the Big Sky championship, and that was a big win for us.
I think he was great for the program. I mean, that's the reason why we're in the Big Sky right now. They're the reason why Bruce Field is Bruce Field.
I was very lucky. I had great assistant coaches at Eastern. But, you know, because we had small staffs, we had to do a lot of work. Like I told you, at one time I'm the athletic director, I'm the head football coach, I'm the strength coach, and I still teach.
Just glad that he's finally been honored because of what he did here at Eastern for all those years.
When you think of coaching icons or coaching models, his name sticks out for Eastern football.
It's been a major part of my life. I had a great time going to school there. I had a great time working there. Enjoyed the people I got the chance to work with. But it has great memories for me. As you get older, memories are pretty important in your life.